Hello everybody, my name is Invicta. Welcome back to Darkest Dungeon Season 2 here. We are ready to go for a very short mission, hopefully in the Warrens. The last time I said that ended up being pretty awful. I don't know why the game decided to switch my party composition, because it wasn't like that before. We've got 4 Strategy Gaming, who's going to be up front. He's going to be tanking and doing all sorts of guardy stuff. Boogie's going to be bringing some damage here. He's rocking the Legendary Bracer, even though you can't see it because of the speech bubble. And the Dismas's Head. NL is going to be providing a little bit of support damage as well as some stuns here. He's going with the Restraining Padlock and the Lock of Fury. And of course, TB is going to be doing the healing. I'm not going to have to upgrade anything because I've already made sure that everyone's good. We already have people in the sanitarium, that sort of thing as well. Should be an easy mission, but I say that knowing that it's probably never going to be an easy mission. We're not going to be doing a dark run, so I am going to bring a couple extra torches just in case we find some scrolls. I don't think that any of these heroes actually need any sort of negative quirk removal, but maybe? I don't know. So I'll also bring I'll bring one bandage and one anti-venom just in case as well. I don't care about holy water. So here we go. Again, should be a fairly easy mission, I hope. This is medium. None of the other trinkets, unfortunately, were really worth doing. So yeah. And we need to get caught up on the Warrens, so.
They breed quickly down there in the dark. But perhaps we can slay them even faster.
All right. So we start off with a surprise here, which is great. Obviously, we probably don't need NL to transform. I would have really preferred that he actually hit, like, his target, but, you know, nice crit there by TB. Now we'll go for a crush, take down the Enchantress, and then Boogie should get the easy dunk. Actually, we should go for a stun here on the Gladiator, just because we don't want him to get the bleed out, and I think that Boogie might be faster than the Gladiator. So they conscript miss, because we don't care about the conscript damage. All right. Try this again. Can NL land a stun? He cannot, because he had 85%. I'm going to go ahead and mark the Gladiator up front. That's just for Boogie. Gladiator's going to get one hit off here and completely whiff on 4 Strategy Gaming. 6 damage from Force. Unfortunately, not good enough. 33 non-crit by Boogie, though. Good lord, Boogie. 2 damage, not that big of a deal. Does lower his dodge a little bit, that's okay.
Alright. Formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Got a little bit of extra food, might as well top somebody off here. There you go, Boogie. Took a whole 2 damage in that fight. Alright, so we've got a Hulking Swinetar, the Marcher, and the Reaver. We're definitely going to have to transform NL here. I think it would be foolish not to, in my opinion. And we'll go for a headbutt, probably. Yes. Because if this works, then we're going to have the Swinetar up front. And he's going to have to use his Trot Retreat up at the front. So that does mark NL. We got to be careful about that. I'm going to go, actually, instead of marking, I'm going to go for a little bit of extra damage on the back line with that. And then Force, I'm going to go ahead and guard NL. Even though he's marked, I don't really want NL to get hit by anything. And we could go for a stun on the Reaver if we really wanted to. I think we should take out the Marcher, though, just because we don't want the stress.
A faint hope blossoms.
Ball and chain on TB. And there's the Trot Retreat that I was just talking about. So having that move, that shuffle on the Swinetar is pretty important. Huge hit by NL. I mean, it was a corpse, but still. Able to get the crit heal there from the corpse. Gonna go ahead and mark up the Hulking Swinetar. It's not gonna drop his protection, however. However, if I use Boogie to do that, that will drop his protection, but I'm not gonna do that. I mean, it's only a medium level mission, so that doesn't mean that we're gonna take it off. One off lead will count it. But I just wanna make sure that we don't have to the faster things get killed, the better. So, and they actually get the move and the stun on 4 Strategy Gaming, and they get a crit. Alright. Oh, that's the reason why they had the one off lethal right there. So let's see what kind of resist we failed this time, team. We failed at 80% and an 80%. Yeah. Alright, well, let's go ahead and take out the Reaver just because.
Give them no quarter.
4 Strategy Gaming is gonna be down there for a while. TB, gonna get the stab. There's a crunching backhand, double dodge. Boogie with only 12 damage. That's like, it's kind of ridiculous, to be honest. 10 damage there from NL. Big 5 damage from TB. We'll go ahead and guard, I guess, NL. Since we're not going to bring Force up, and he can't use Rampart from the back line.
Size alone does not dissuade.
All right, so we had some standard BSery there, but we end up coming out of it okay. Now this is an Eldritch Idol, which we are not going to be able to utilize, but that will usually purge a negative quirk on somebody. But you need a Holy Water to do so. And there's a good old trap.
Traps lie in wait, unsprung and thirsting for blood.
So we got some spiders here. Should not need to use anything. Luckily, it did hit the only person that can take care of themselves as far as stress is concerned.
Confidence surges. TV
getting one
as the
kill.
Enemy crumbles.
Yeah, I think going for a crush. Probably should have gone for the riposte instead. Let's take out the spitter just because I don't want to deal with blight.
Executed with impunity.
The two Webbers shouldn't be that big of a deal, especially if they miss like that. They got the mark, but not the stun on Boogie, which is good. Although they are going to be able to go again, which is not good. So there's the blight. Go ahead and heal up Boogie a little bit. Did not proc the bleed. I appreciate that, TB. For some reason, they're biting the non-marked target, which is very odd. Just gonna go ahead and use this time to heal up NL, get rid of some of his stress. Four strategy gaming, and Boogie should be able to take care of those. There we go.
To the pit.
Spider not able to go again. Surprising.
Another abomination cleansed from our land.
There we go. So NL gets the crit. No big deal. Spiders go down.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
We go ahead and clear out the rubble, and we got ourselves a sack. First hunger event. Not that big of a deal. Since this is a short mission, we obviously don't need to camp or anything like that. And we did proc scouting, so this is 100% room battles, and wouldn't you know it, we've got a lot more to go. Alright, might not be as short of a run as I would have originally guessed, but we got ourselves lots of fighting going on. I'm actually not going to transform NL for this fight until I have to. Go for a stun on the cutthroat. And missed the 45% chance. Or missed the 45% resist, I mean. It was a, whenever I get to go again, I'll be able to show you how badly we missed on that. We missed 129 on 45. It's pretty good. Definitely want to go for the retribution here.
A decisive pummeling.
Nice crit by 4 Strategy Gaming. I'm going to go for a shank on an L. Damage to the back line. It's unfortunate that Boogie is so slow. But we get the main DPS threat out of there, at least. And I think going for a stun on the Bloodletter would be good. Hey, we hit that 70%. That's got to be worth something, right? More damage here. If you're wondering why I'm not healing with TB yet, it's because no one's really needed it. There's the riposte coming in from Force. And we might as well take advantage of the Headhunter there with the stun target. Finish him, I mean, not Headhunter. And yeah. Oh, Force. Wow. Remember, he's got minus 15% damage because of the tough ring, by the way.
Low and driven into the mud.
I'm not worried about using the bandage on NL because, well,
as the light gains purchase,
if he needs a heal, he can heal himself without us having to use a bandage.
And purpose is made clear.
I mean, yes, he's bleeding, but it's not for a whole lot of damage. So out come the wretches and out come the marchers. Hopefully we get the stun here, which we did. Nice crit by TV.
Quakes.
Could not get the kill. I really want to take out the Marcher, but I really don't want the wretch to do anything. So he's going to use Trot Retreat. That's fine. Has a very high chance to miss. NL gets the kill with the chain. We probably should heal somebody. Yeah. Nice. Good job, TB. Great heal. And we got the bleed too, so there's that. Nice kill there by Force. And And we could try to go for a stun. I'm just going to mark him instead of drop his protection. We're going to take a lot of damage here. Maybe. Yeah, especially if they crit. And we failed the 80% move resist again. And we failed the 80% stun resist again. All right. Good old Force Strategy Gaming. Start stacking the Blight here. Yeah, we should probably heal. All right, another great heal. Good job, DB. Wonderful. Showing off those occultist heals. I'm going to keep stripping the protection here on the Swine Tar. He's down to 5% now. Good dodge my boogie. Apparently that crit... I didn't even know that that did contact damage. Apparently it does. Big 38 damage there with Boogie. Here comes the Trout Retreat. It's gonna miss. Usually misses. Man, everybody's just critting up a storm here. Alright, well, he's dead. So, hopefully we can get a heal off here on Force. And now we're gonna go ahead and have him heal himself. Just because, get a heal off in Force. I mean, 9 is better, I suppose. Might as well try for the final crit.
Size has no intrinsic merit, unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
Let's go ahead and drop that. Do we need busts for anything? Don't recall. We also don't know if there's going to be a shovel event. I guess I'll get rid of the bandage. And I'll get rid of the anti-venom. I'll probably end up regretting that. More gold is fine. Another trap that missed is also fine. Yep, and there's our bandage curio. Alright.
The light. The promise of safety.
Alright, so we've got at least one more fight. Make that 2 fights. I could skip this fight, but come on. We gotta fight. We gotta at least fight on a short. This is like, what, 5 or 6 total fights in this this short mission. That's pretty good. I meant to actually go for the stun there, but alright. Go, and another crit.
Strike.
Total biscuit, just going ham. So I'm gonna rend Force. Even Force gets a crit on the riposte. It's pretty good. Good job by Force. Now we can go for a stun here. One off lethal, count it. Definitely want to get a heal on Force. There we go. That's the kind of TB heals that we know and love. Go for a stun here. Might as well not let them attack. Alright, so we know that the Blight is going to kill them next turn, so we don't even have to attack him. This gives us an extra time to top off an L. TB can also heal probably Boogie or somebody. Somebody like that. 54 heal! That might be a new record. No, that's actually not a new record for heal. I believe that my healing record, my single target heal ever, the highest I've ever healed was 62. But wow, that was a pretty impressive heal. It's a shame that there's not a mechanic that overheals give like shields or like heals over time or something in the game. I really don't want to transform an elf if we don't have to. So I'm gonna try not to. Definitely want to get a riposte down here. And then Boogie, I'm actually gonna go for the stun and not go for a kill on the Marcher. The less attacks that we can force or that we can remove from the spawn, the better.
Ears, blurred vision, the end approaches.
I go for the Butcher's Cut on NL. The Swine's in the second position. He's still going to get an attack off regardless. The riposte did not kill him, unfortunately. There we go. Alright, so we got that. Let's go ahead and go for a crush on the gore. TV should be able to get a kill here. There we go. Here come the drums. There's the riposte kill. Good job, Force. And we can stun the Reaver. Alright. So it wasn't too bad. It was a little bit longer than I was anticipating, and that was due to the ridiculous amount of fights that was in this run. There was quite a bit. Go for a Blight. Try to burn through some of that protection a little bit. And Boogie. Take down one of the corpses. That way we can collect bounty of the next turn. 7 damage from Force. Probably you're not gonna land this stun. I'm just gonna keep spamming AoE here. We might get another stress heal or something. Let's go ahead. Well, go ahead and heal Boogie just in case. Proc the bleed. And Boogie should get the smackdown here. Yep. 24, not bad. So without having any direct stress healing here, we've actually done quite well on this run.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
We'll go ahead and open up this chest really fast, but yeah, I mean, a fairly solid, easy run. Surprisingly, when you can come away from the Warrens without a lot of stress and without any diseases, that's even more impressive and important.
Just work,
we'll go ahead and take it. We also get 13 G's in the bank and 18 crests. Not too bad, Boogie. Of course, I spoke too soon. Yeah, there's our double disease. Never mind. Just don't listen to anything I say about this game. Darkest Dungeon's gonna get
competition
that.
Competition fosters skill and confidence.
I mean, Tempo's our only arbalist, so can't do much about that. Let's go ahead and treat Boogie and TB real quick. Those two out of there. We'll unequip all the trinkets. And I don't know if there was anyone else left that had negative quirks. I think I caught everyone up again. Nope. Maggie, she's got a Hylomania. We'll give her a +5 dodge too. That's a pretty spicy meatball, but we'll go ahead. I guess Maggie's worth it. Scattering, yeah, we don't really want that on TB, but he's in treatment right now. Oh man, never mind. Forrest has a long way to go. All right, Zoophobia, and all right, we don't have to worry about that. Jared, NL, I saw that Fear of Mankind, so you got to go back in the naughty box. And can we get what else are we looking for? Another jester. We've got our two Houndmasters. We've got another Vestal. I think a second Arbalist wouldn't be that bad. How many Vestals do we have? Let's see. We have Jenna. It's 2. We only have 3. I'd like to get another Vestal. That one's not too bad. Lurker Cove Explorer. Warren's Phobe would have to get taken care of as opposed to just one. Elder Slayer, Mankind Hater, Warren's Phobe. Yeah, we can go ahead. We can bring this one. Yeah. All right. So we'll get ourselves another vessel.
A sister of battle. Pious
and we only
and
have
unrelenting.
3 jesters. Would probably like a 4th. How are you? Bad gambler. I mean, this is great. This is actually really great here because he's got 2 negative quirks that we just don't care about. So yeah, definitely pick him up.
You will be laughing still at the end.
And I think that's going to do it. So not bad. Let's go ahead and take a preview of what we've got coming up tomorrow. Not quite there in the Warrens yet for the next round of bosses. We've got a Dark Tambourine from the Hag. Another Tough Ring from the Fulminating Prophet. And the Wounding Helmet from the Alluring Siren. Ancestor's Ring's pretty good. Don't care about the garlic. Fleet Florin's not bad. We might be going back to the Warrens just to bolster that one. Alright, well anyway, I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your day. And as always, I'll see you all in the next episode here. And again, I do appreciate the support on the Darkest Dungeon Season 2 series. Until next time, so long, everybody!